Good evening, Yarnies, Dirty Hook-ers, and Fiber Fiends. How is everyone doing this evening? Oh, no, no, no. Oh, I'm feedback. I don't want that. I'm pretty good. How is everyone? Sorry I had to cancel the past two streams. Things came up, but I am back. Granny Karen is not here tonight since I had to cancel two streams. I'm going to play some catch-up. Mine went blank. So what I had planned for today's what, Thursday? For Tuesday, we can either do that tonight, or we can do what was kind of planned for tonight, sort of, kind of. I'm going to let everyone vote on that. Let me get this check on the thing. Hey there, Black Rose, and just a curious brain cell, and thank you for the Lark Spy Guy, and everyone else that is coming into the stream. Already here. So I'm going to give it a few more minutes so some more people come in, and we could possibly show what we're going to be, our choices are. We're going to let you guys decide. So we can either learn a new stitch, or I can work on another brand new project. Let me get things off to the side a little bit. And my sample, this stitch that I may or may not teach or show you, share everyone, it likes to curl. All right. So I guess I can show this real quick before we do any of the voting. So this is what I was going to be doing on Tuesday. This is, I've stretched this so it'll lay flat. It is the cross to ripple stitch. Let me zoom in. So you can see how it's got these diagonal twisted, almost a braid look to this stitch. It has a right and a wrong side. That is the right side. So that's the pretty side. This is the back. The back's not that bad, but this is not the attractive side. That's the back. And this is the front. So we could learn how to do this. Or I can make this. This is called the Sweetheart Soiree. Doily. I found this actually by accident in a crochet group on Facebook the other day. It's a free pattern. It would take a little while to do. Obviously, I can't do the entire thing tonight, but yeah, it is very pretty. I don't have any pink thread. I do have some red thread that I could do. And then I would trim it in, like, the outer round or two. It's got, like, a white. I would probably do it in a cream color or an off-white. So, this is going to be done eventually anyway. I will be doing this doily. I thought it was really pretty and appropriate for Valentine's Day, which, in about a month. So, we have that, or we have this. Hey there, Moth. How are you? Welcome in. So I'm going to leave it up to everybody to choose. And let me see something here. Yeah, we're going to do a poll. We're going to do a good old-fashioned poll, if I remember how to do the thing. I'm just, okay, well, I guess I'm not, okay. There we go. And I'm going to allow multiple votes. And we're going to give it for 5 minutes. Alrighty, so there's the poll. It should be showing up. Maybe. Maybe. Did I do it right? Yes, yes, yes. There's a poll in the chat. You can do multiple votes. You can vote as many times as you want. You can't decide. Both are good. Well, if you want to do the pink one to be pink, save until you have the proper threat. Oh, it doesn't... I don't mind if it's pink, if it's white, if it's green, if it's orange, if it's chartreuse with purple polka dots. The color doesn't bother me. And again, I don't have to make it exactly the way that they did on the their example. So, again, I should actually do that. Let me do this. Okay, so there's this. It's called the Sweetheart Soiree. I can't. It's French. The Heart Doily or the Crossed Ripple. Now, I'm probably going to do both eventually, but it's which one am I going to do first. This is a teaching. This I will teach. This is a... I'll go step by step and teach you how to do this. And the doily, that's not going to be teaching. That's going to be just me working on a project and getting through it at some point. Hey there, why are you so salty? How are you? I did not forget about the needlepoint. The needlepoint will be here hopefully soon. I mean, it's here, but it'll be on stream hopefully soon. I'm shooting for next week. Shooting soon next week. If it's a tie, couple do a sweetheart cross soiree ripple doily. Yes. Yes. And we'll have a big rat's nest of thread. Oh, good. Just working on your cross stitch. Nice. What is the cross stitch of? What is the design? What is the... I guess that's the word, the design. And if you have if anybody has any pictures, feel free to post them in the Discord. Love to see that. When we go to our ad break, it's a Super Pokemon Gen 1 cross stitch. Oh, nice. That seems familiar. Have you shared that in my Discord? Or I may have seen it in someone else's Discord. That sounds very familiar. I'm scrolling back and I don't see it. Yeah, I don't see it. Finally broke down and decided to make it. Gotcha. Yeah, I saw somebody, I was on someone's stream or someone's Discord, and there was a Pokemon. Maybe I'm remembering things wrong. I don't know. Just started. It's pretty popular. Large cross. Yes. I've done some sizable cross stitches. I've never done any like huge ones. And all the ones I've ever done were kits. I've never done the ones where you supply the your own fabric and floss. So let me check and see how do I do this? Size of a poster and it's full. Oh, and full coverage. I've done... The one kit I did was not technically full coverage. It was almost full coverage. It's actually hanging in our kitchen. Yeah. Let me see the other ones. Welcome in, Crafting Sam. How are you? Don't look. Wait. Why can't Moth look? Oh, because Moth is streaking. Yeah, let's not look. So, yeah, I'm trying to think of other cross stitches I've done if they will be full coverage, but I don't think they are. Anyway, how are you, Sam? So right now, the sweetheart that is winning. I didn't take French. I took 1 year of Spanish in middle school. So, I was wrong. I was wrong. The Ripple Crochet one. Wow. Ripple Crochet with 52% and the doily was 48%. That was close. Yes, you did say chaos. Don't look, Ethel. Yeah. Spy Guy, I know that song. Ray Stevens. All right. So we are going to go and do the cross ripple stitch. So, yes. Yes. When I was a kid, we watched. Well, we actually, you know, there were some videos. Listened to a lot of Ray Stevens. All right. Okay, this music, I'm not liking that song. Okay, so, you want to know how to do this? Okay, we can do this. I decided to put this stitch in because it's kind of related to cabling. And somebody had asked previously, weeks ago, about the cable stitch. So next week, and actually works great, next week I'm going to do the cable stitch. How much yarn do you need? That all depends on your project. I'm going to do a sample. I'm going to do a small sample. You can do this, I didn't even show this. Well, it's just shown, but... My tatting book fell. Incoming. This is from the book called Crochet Stitch Dictionary by Sarah Hazel. And this is the cross ripple stitch. I should have read this to see what this would be good for. Hard wearing, beautiful texture. Okay, it doesn't say what it would be good for. But it is a... there's some thickness. There's some thickness to it. You have a smallish ball of white? Yeah, if you want to. We're just going to do a small little sample. Hey there, Sky by Queen. Crafting today? Crocheting a tote bag. Oh, nice. Again, if you have any progress picks, anybody, pop those in the Discord. You're one of the ones who asked about the cable stitch. Yes. So this is basically an intro to cabling. I try to find something that would be easing us into it because cabling can get a little more involved. So it does a similar type motion with the cabling. So yes, if anybody's going to crochet along with me, grab whatever yarn. I'm just using this small ball of yarn here. We're just going to do a small little swatch. And... whatever hook is recommended or that you normally use with the yarn that you have. And that's how it is with most crochet patterns. Again, the hook is just determining your gauge. I'm using some scrap worsted white yarn, which I don't know where it came from. It is kind of scratchy. It's not the best. It's probably, I don't know, decades old. And I'm using a 5.5 millimeter hook. Use whatever you got. Second person accidentally call me that spy guy, the traveling tatter. Yeah, yes. Yes. Both me and Tatter interact with Spy Guy a lot, and we say his name frequently, so yeah. Sky and Spy. Yes, this is a weight of four. Yeah, a weight of four. But again, if you know crochet, just because they give a recommended hook. There's a noise outside my window. Just because they give a recommended hook on the label doesn't mean that's the hook you have to use. Use whatever that you need to obtain gauge. Right now, gauge is not going to be important tonight. Because we're just learning the stitch. We're not actually making an actual item. So this pattern is actually a two-row repeat once we establish the first couple rows. All right, so if anybody's crocheting along, let me know. I know Sam is. I will go slow enough. So for our foundation, so our chain, it's going to be a multiple of three stitches. So if you're going to do 3, 6, 9, 12, so on, however wide you want to make it, then plus 2 and plus an additional 1 for the foundation chain. So let me repeat that. The multiple for the finished, for this piece here, it's 3 plus 2. But for the foundation chain, your beginning chain, you add one more. So if that makes any sense. So I'm just going to do 12. Going to do a slip knot on my hook like you normally would do. And I'm going to chain 12. I have 12. I'm only going to do a small little sample. This one, I think I did 30 or 28 or whatever. You're not going to use a pattern, just going to make it as you go along. Oh, for the tote bag. I've done that before. I've made it up as I've gone along. So you've got your multiple of 3 for your chain. So that's how many stitches we're going to have in the actual pattern. That will be the multiple plus 2, and then one more for the foundation chain. So I have my chain is 15. Yeah, math. Thank you for the lurk, Blue Raven. Not feeling well. All right, I hope you feel better. And if you feel better and you when you with your singing lessons, hope you have a good time. And thank you for being here. So I've got my starting chain. It was 12 plus 3 more, which makes it 15. It's a multiple of 3. Once you have your starting chain, you're going to single crochet. Okay, that song's a little loud. You're going to single crochet into the second chain from the hook. Let's zoom in a little more. That's as far as I can zoom in. So we've got our chain. We're going to single crochet in the second chain from the hook. And we're going to single crochet in the remaining chains. So you're just going to do one row of single crochet. This song is weird. Not going to be here long. It's literally already 11:30 and you got an exam. Nope, I understand that. If anybody needs to go and do other things, get sleep. Definitely get that done. That's more important than watching an idiot crochet on the internet. You're just doing a row of single crochet. The count, the chain count. Don't talk about your friend like that. I know I'm not. The key is the chain count. Again, it's a multiple of 3 plus 2. That is your multiple for the finished piece. But with your foundation chain gets one more chain. So I had 15 chains and I single crocheted into the second chain from the hook and all the way across. So now I have 14 single crochets because again, you skip that first chain because that first chain is your turning chain. And I will wait until if anybody is crocheting along to get caught up to that. That is the easiest part. I don't know if I should make the first panel of the bag long ways or short ways. Well, you could try it one way, and after you get the first panel done and you kind of like look at it and you kind of envision it, then if you don't like it, you could far cut out and redo it. Single crochet at the end. Is it one chain at the end? Oh, you mean for your when you get to the dot your turning chain for the next round? When you get to the end of your sing, you do your very last single crochet in the last chain, then you're going to chain 3. I chain and turn Some people turn, then chain. I think it's a preference. True, but that's long. Yeah, you'd rather decide now. I mean, it's however you want the rows or the stitches to go, if you want them to go vertical or horizontal. All right, so at the end of the row, we're going to chain three. That is our turning chain for this next row, and we're going to turn. Now, so that turning chain, the chain of three, counts as a double crochet. We're going to skip the first stitch. So where that chain is coming out of, that stitch here, we're going to skip that. And the next two. So skip one, two, and three. And then the very next stitch, so it's actually the fourth one. One, two, three, four. The fourth one over. We're going to do a double crochet. And my yarn splits because this is old and not really good yarn. That's why I use it for demonstration purposes because it's not something I want in a piece. Two, three, four. So in the fourth chain. Did somebody just subscribe to me? I didn't get a notification. My subscriber goal was met. Oh, thank you, everybody. You got Jell-O? Nice. Yeah, I think just flashed on my screen. I don't know what that meant. It said subscriber goal meant. Alright, so we did our chain three, counts as a double. We're going to skip the stitch it's coming out of and the next two. So skip those three. And then the fourth one, do a double. And after you do that double, you're going to chain one. And now the tricky part comes. So we're going to yarn over like we're going to do a double, because we will do a double. And those stitches we skipped. So we skipped this one, and this one. So from where we did this double here, we're going to count back two. One, two. And in that second one, we're going to do a double into that stitch. So to recap, we chain three and turn. Skip the one it's coming out of. Skip the next two. And in the very next one, do a double. Chain one. And then do a double into the stitch that's two stitches back from where we did this double. So it's coming out of there. Well, it's in there. One, two. You go back. And then you do a double. And what you're going to, when you do this double, this stitch here that you made, you're going to be stitching over. So let me show again. We're going to yarn over. And we go, that's where it's joined to. Skip this one. And then the next one we go into. And we're going to be stitching over that last double that we made. And we're going to do the double, like you normally would. So that is the cross. And the repeat now is, we're going to skip two stitches. So what we have to do, the way I do this, to make it easy, hopefully I'm explaining this correctly, or clearly, I should say. So when we started, we had the chain three, skip three stitches, and in the fourth stitch, put in a double, chain one, and then go back two stitches and put in a double. Now, where that first double, where this double was, where it was going into, from there, because that's the one we crossed over top of, we're going to skip. You got to check the kids. Okay. If you want, I can hold off. I could definitely hold off on this. And if anybody's confused with this, let me know. Because this can be a little confusing at first. Hey there, Knitter Girl. Temperature's -30. Feels like -44. extreme cold warning. Ooh. Be careful. Stay inside. Stay warm. Let me get my pointer out so I can probably show these stitches a little bit better. But how is everyone else doing? What is everyone working on? We are learning the crossed ripple stitch, which is a beginner, I would call a beginner version to crochet, cable crochet. Possibility of snow? Yeah, we're supposed to get rain here tomorrow. They're still eating? Okay. You have snow? Ew. Yeah, I don't like it. Don't like it. So, Crafting Sin, do you want me to redo and recap this here? I don't want to confuse you. Because I can rip this out and redo it. That's why I love crochet. You can always rip it out and start over. Well, it's one of the reasons I like crochet. Tiny bit of snow, but it didn't settle. Yeah. Here, the ground's still too warm. You did the third? Okay, so you did the chain, the double, and then the cross double. Okay. So when I learned this stitch the other week, yes, I just learned this stitch. I've learned to put my finger under this one here, the one to the far left, and to see where it's coming, where it's attached to. So then from there, I'm gonna skip two stitches, and then in the third stitch, I'm gonna put in a double. So you're forming this large loop. And then we're going to chain one. And we're going to count back two stitches. And in that second stitch back, we're going to put in a double crochet. You're going to do that all the way to the end. And when we get to the end, we'll have one stitch left over. So again, to recap that, I'm going to keep going. That is where the stitch that I made that sits furthest to the left, I'm going to find where that is, and from there, I'm going to skip two stitches, one, two, and in the third stitch, put in a double. I'm going to chain one, and from where that stitch is, I'm going to count back two. And in that second stitch back, one, two, I'm going to do a double. It's not really going to seem like much the first couple rows you do, because it's all going to look a little strange. But as you do more, it'll make sense. So now I'm going to put my finger and find where this stitch, the one to the far left, so this angled stitch here, where that was connected. And from there, I'm going to skip two and then put in a double. I'm going to chain one. And from where this stitch that I just did, that double, I'm going to count back two and put in a double. So it's you're taking three steps forward and two steps back. That's basically how this works. So you're going to do that to the end, and when you get to the end of your row, you should have one stitch left, and in that very last stitch, you're going to put in a double. Again, if this is confusing anybody, and you want me to redo that row, I'm willing to rip that all out and show you how to do it again. What I'm going to do... And the instructions doesn't tell me to do this, but I'm going to count. because I know how many stitches I should have. My original chain, when I first made my foundation chain, was 15. It should be one less. So I'm going to count the tops of my stitches, those V's, to make certain I have 14 for this. And the 14th one will be the top of your turning chain, if you count that way. 1, 2. Yes, if you're doing the same size piece as me, you have four of these crossed ripples, yes. And at the very end, and if you look at it this way, your turning chain, your three chains, counts as a double crochet. So we're going to say we have a double crochet at the beginning, and at the end we have a double crochet. So you're going to start and stop your row with a double crochet. So row three is super easy, super easy. You're going to chain one and turn, and each stitch gets a single crochet, but I would recommend not holding it here and looking this way. I would make certain you're going under each stitch and looking at the V's. Even though I've been crocheting for a couple decades now, I've been known to miss, especially those chains that you do. So I'm going to single crochet. So we chained one and turned. I'm going to single crochet into each stitch, and I'm going to turn it so I can see that my hook Thank you for the follow, Sassacass. I've been in your stream before. Welcome in. I am going to give you a shout out. Oh, I don't think they've probably followed me from another stream that meant message. Oh, no, Sasa is there. Do the thing.
Bottom middle. Oh my god. No, it's okay. Try the other side.
Oh. If you're not following Sassacass and that spy guy, check them out. Sassacass, I know the last time I was in your stream the other week, I know you've been working on this for a while. You're doing a very large Lord of the Rings cross stitch, full coverage piece, and it is amazing. I'm not a Lord of the Rings fan. I've never seen any of the movies. I've only seen clips and commercials, but it is gorgeous. So if you're not following Sassacass, check them out. Some great work over there. And if you're not following that spy guy, you need to follow him. He does cross stitch and diamond painting. So lots of fun over there. And no, there are not, you did not hear this from me, there is not kazoo playing over there. So I don't know why I said that. But so yes, welcome in everybody. And again, thank you for the follow. So this row here that we're working on, the it's a stitch called the cross ripple stitch. I'm teaching it. I do a lot of teaching here on my stream. No, spy guy. I said there is not kazoo playing over there. All right. So for this row, you're going to go and do a single into each stitch. And I know I'm going to have 14 of them because it's one less than my original chain, because this sample has 15. And sometimes some of these stitches gets a little tight. I try my best. If I have to go around the stitch, like if it's a chain here, I'll do that. I try to get like here. That's where I did the chain one. That's very difficult sometimes because I am a tight hooker. I'll just go around the actual, like that right there. I won't go into the chain. I'll just go around it. Nobody's gonna know. And if they know, it's none of their business. It's my stitch. It's my chain. It's my hook. My yarn. They need to mind their own business. So you're gonna do one single into each stitch, all the way across, including at the very end here, your turning chain from the previous row. That counts as one. So in my case, I had 14 across. Okay, this, and anytime you're doing single crochet on this pattern, you're working on the back side of the piece. Because this will have a front, a right and a wrong side. So this is the wrong side. So when you get to the end of that row, you're going to chain three and turn. All right, Sam, we'll be here. I can wait for you. It's actually a lot easier once you get to this point here because you actually have stitches, actual stitches instead of chains. And I hate working into a chain. And that reminds me of something. We're going to be doing something here real quick. If I can find the thing. Give me a second. Losing my mind. I didn't even set that up, did I? Should have set that up before stream, but I didn't. It's all good. I'm just talking to myself. But how is everyone else? What is everyone else working on? I know Sky by Queen is making a tote bag and I completely forgot. Don't mind me. There's just and it's Black Rose. Are you the one doing the No, it's What Why Are You So Salty that's doing the cross stitch. Short attention span. Short-term memory loss. Okay, welcome back. So we've got our last row was all singles, and we chain three and turn. And for this row, and this is where we're going to start the alternating rows. So the next for this row, we're going to skip the first stitch. Does Cub know some of your whips? The only one I remember, and I think you're still working on it, is that blanket where there's like rectangles, like panels that have the popcorn or the bobble stitch, and then you're gonna piece them together. And I think there's like it's got like words formed out of the bobbles or popcorns, and I think it's got a dinosaur, like a triceratops maybe. See, I remember some of. There's so many people I interact with either on my stream or other streams. And so many discords I'm in that I see everyone's work, and it gets to a point where I think everybody's making the same thing. I'm not saying I'm old, but I'm older, and memory, yeah. All right. Yes, it does blur together. So I chain three and turned, and we're going to skip the very first stitch and the next two stitches. So we're going to skip one, two, and three. We're going to yarn over because we're doing a double. So skip those three, and in the fourth one, do a double crochet. And after you do the double crochet, we're going to chain one. And where this double crochet is joined to, we're going to count back two stitches. And do a double crochet just like we did on this previous row down here. Now this is where I'm gonna like get my finger after I do those three, the turning chain, the double, and then the next double. So those are three doubles. Then I'm gonna yarn over, and I'm gonna find where this double here joined, and can skip two stitches from there, and then the next stitch, do a double, chain one. Then yarn over. Again, if I'm going way too fast for anybody, I tend to do that. So let me know. So I've chained one. I'm going to yarn over. And from where this joined, I'm going to count back two spaces. And in the second space, the second stitch, we're going to do a double. And that's the pattern. So we did that. We're going to yarn over because we're going to do a double. I'm going to find where this first double we did of that grouping, and from there skip two, and then the third one do a double, chain one, and then yarn over, and from where it connected count back two and do a double. Again, yarn over. Find where this stitch, there's a stitch right here. There's a stitch right here where that joined. From there, we're going to skip two or go into the third stitch. One, two, three. So you're taking three steps forward and do a double. Chain one. And then we're going to do a double, but we're going to go two steps back. Two steps back and do the double. And when you get to the end of the row, your very last stitch should have a double. And that's the repeat. Now it's going to look a little different in my yarn, this yarn here, because this is not the most fluffy yarn. This one's a little bit fluffier. So my stitches are going to be a little more flat. But you can see the crossed patterns, and it forms a little bit of a ripple. And the more and more you do it, especially if you stitch tight like I do, this will curl like this. Yes, these are very simple ones. And so the next row, we're going to chain one and turn. Each stitch gets one single. So the wrong side is the basic single crochet. So this row takes no thinking, or very little thinking. Blanket curls. So yes, yeah, that's how I am. Again, I'm a tight hooker, so most of my crochet will curl, especially the corners. But once you get more of it done, then it'll start to relax and lay flat. And always remember, when you're doing your single crochet at the very end, put a stitch in the top of that turning chain, because that turning chain counts as a stitch. And then for row, see, this is already curling. So row, the next row is you chain up three and turn, and then you do the same thing. Three steps forward, two steps back. So we did our turning chain. I'm going to yarn over because we're going to do a double. We're going to skip this one, and this one. So you're going to skip three. And then this stitch here, we're going to do a double, chain one, and now do a double but two steps back. And you're only going to do the chain one in between your stitch that is moving in the forward direction, and between that one and the one that you go back. So you find where this is coming, where this is attached to, and from there you just go one, two, three steps forward, chain one, and then two steps back. Okay, that's where it's connected. You go three steps forward. So in the third one, chain one, and then you do two steps back. Okay. One, two, three. Chain one, and then two steps back. The only time that you're doing chains, well, on that row, you're doing all double crochets except the chain that's in between the three steps forward, two steps back. Everything else is a double. And that's the pattern. So more and more that you do it, you can, I mean, it kind of forms like these little square, almost squares here. But then at the top and the bottom of those squares, it's got a little twist, a little chain, not a chain, a cable. And then when we do real cables, we're going to do a similar type thing, except you're going to do multiple of them, of stitches back. So you'll probably do, I don't know, there's different versions of it. I have a basic chain, not chain, cable pattern. But like you go, like you skip like four stitches and then you go back two, well, you go back a bunch of them and you do multiple. So you're basically twisting your stitches. And the back, this isn't curled yet, but that's the back. The back isn't that bad. That is the crossed ripple. I'm going to do another row. So now I'm doing a row of singles. This does make a little bit of a thicker fabric. You could probably still do this for a blanket because it's not super thick. It's not going to be like heavy. This is a little bit durable because you're in parts of it. It's two thicknesses essentially because you got stitches over top of stitches. I can see this if you had the strength, the upper body strength, and used a larger hook and like a sisal type rope, not a heavy rope, but like a thicker rope, like a rattan, not a rattan, like a sisal type rope, that would make a really good doormat because it'd have a really interesting texture. Oh, I didn't check. Okay. I turned then chained. Okay, I didn't do what I normally do, but it's fine. It's just showing you that you can do either way. So I've got my turning chain that counts as a double. I'm going to yarn over. I'm going to skip where it's coming from. And the next three. So we're going to ignore the one here all the way in the edge. Skip those two. And that third one. And wait, one, two, three. Yeah. One, two. I said that wrong. Skip that one and the next two, and then go into the fourth one. So that's your three steps forward, chain one, and now two steps back. And then you find where that double there is connected. And you go three steps forward, one, two, and then the third one, chain one, and then two steps back. And then go one, two, three, chain one, and two steps back. And then if I did this right, one, two, and then three, yep. After that stitch, there'll be one stitch left here. So I did that right. And then we did our three steps forward, two steps back. And now we're going to do a double into that last stitch. Okay. Oh, it's a cool looking pattern. Does anybody have any questions? Again, this is from the book Crochet Stitch Dictionary by Sarah Hazel. I really like this book because I'm not going to show you all the pattern, but they give a color example, they give a chart, And they give, well, they give Charger the steps, but they also give the written instructions. So I really like this book. So it's for... Do I have a link to the book? No. I got this off of Amazon. Actually, you know what? I'm going to find it on Amazon. You can get it pretty much anywhere that sells books. I've even seen it. I think a couple times I've seen it at Michael's. But. I'm going to find this here. I got it right here for you. Oh, that's a horrible, horrible link. Sorry about that. But, that will get you to it. I'll end up posting a link to it in, my Discord. And I should post it for it to come up periodically in chat. But it's got about 200 stitches. They show you the basics. They even show you... Yeah, that is a chunky link. That is a cursed link. Hey there, Caramel. How are you? Happy Friday Eve. Hope everyone's enjoying the day. Yes, I am having a good day today. Also, in the beginning here, we can thumb through a little bit. It shows little color swatches of each stitch. And it'll give the number. The number's the stitch number, not the page number. And I like, very colorful. And the one thing that I like here is in the beginning, they give you diagrams of how to hold the yarn, ways of holding the yarn, and intro basic stuff. They give you suggestions on how to join and seaming, if you want to seam pieces together. They do the, and they talk about gauge, basic stuff. But in the beginning here, they do the basic stitches, like the singles, the doubles, the triples. They have variations like back loop or front loop. They did talk about front post and back post stitches, clusters, puffs, bobbles, popcorns. They also do bullion stitches, which we did a bullion stitch last spring, and I did back in June when I had a garden theme. Month we did a snail, a granny square that had was a snail, and he used bullion stitches. I'm not a fan of those. They are difficult to do. There is a workaround that you can use a latch hook tool to do it. That's the only way I can do it. Loop stitches, which we did loop stitches for the one of the gnome squares for the beard. And they talk about Solomon's knots, which I showed how to do them on stream, I think, last year. So, not just your basic stuff. They get really involved, and they can get really intricate stitches that are in this book. So, and they're all color, bright and colorful, and like I said, about 200 different stitches. I am not... anyway affiliated with this book or the author or the publisher, and they also talk about crochet symbols to help reading a chart, but I recommend this for anybody. We're gonna have an ad here in 20 seconds. I was a little slow on that. I was running my mouth, and when we get back, we're gonna go and check the Discord. There may or may not be something over there, and then we will see what we're gonna do. So I will be right back.
Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the retreat.
Welcome back, everybody. Alrighty. Thank you for sitting through that ad. How dare you come in and cause chaos when it's breakdown? Sorry, Stu. You have to have timing. That's all. It all has to do with timing. I guess your timing is off. Freezing. Yeah, it's a little chilly here. It's not technically freezing. Temperature feels like 30. It's 30, but negative 30 feels like negative 43. Yeah, oof. Bundle up. All right. Let's see here real quick. Okay. We're going to do some Discord shares real quick. We've only got a few of those. The first one is for me. I can show the picture on Discord, but I'm going to show the actual object. You want to be warm? Yeah, I want to be warm. Alrighty, so we have a finish. I finished some tatting. Let me zoom on out. So the piece, I think I started this on New Year's. I knew it. I'll be right back. Thank you, Sue. Okay, well, am I going to do the... Now you're going to make me do the thing and the thing and the thing. Okay, we're doing the thing. Hey there, Fairy Dust. How are you? Welcome in. Let me move my lamp out of the way. Now, I was told... the other day by Clay Miko to wear the turkey hat maybe the other way around. So the way I've been wearing it is like this, and the wings are to the back. I'm going to do it the other way around, like she mentioned. And see how well... Okay, now they're all off. Now the legs are to the back. So, I don't know if that looks right or not. Yes, a Viking turkey hat. Okay, it's weird. I don't know what she was thinking. And also, why is it all lopsided? I got a lopsided turkey. I don't think it's the turkey. I think it's me. Thank you, Sue, for... helping me stay warm. Okay. As I was saying, okay, welcome in, Fairy Dust. How are you? I already said that. Just catching up with chat. Yes, it is funnier. So I started this on New Year's Eve, I think. Yeah. So I finished my second needle tatting piece. That was my first. This is my second. There are mistakes. It's not perfect. But again, I'm just starting out, so I'm pleased with it. It actually looks really good, in my opinion. I like the color combination, so yay for me. All right, we're going to go and do the Discord thing. Words, brain, not working. Okay. All right, first up is from Upcycly. This is square number 52 of 63. She is so close to getting all the squares done. This is going to be a blanket that she is making for her stepdaughter using her Hi there, Seagam. So it is going to be a blanket for Upcycly's stepdaughter using Upcycly's late mother-in-law's yarn and some of her own yarn. So it's going to be a gift for, like I said, her stepdaughter. And each square are the same size, or roughly the same size, but they're different stitches. And this is called the up and down stitch. So she's making lots of progress. Again, she's on that square 52 of 63. So she is almost there to the finish line. Well, then afterwards she has to connect all of them together. But making good progress over there. Everybody is happy to see me. Thanks for the excitement. Yes, we're happy to see you. And we have something from Fairy Dust. Fairy Dust messaged me with this the other day. And this is a Fairy Dust original. My hat started out as a sunburst granny square and just did a little basic mosaic as I went. Yes, this is a Fairy Dust original design, and I think it looks great. I love this mosaic pattern here. These, like, nesting square pattern. Very, very cool. We love it. We love it. That is all we have for the Discord share. But we're not done with some sharing some things. Excuse me while I do this. We are bringing back the meme of the stream segment, and I gotta set this up. Give me a second. I was not prepared for this. So let's move this down. All right, I found a meme earlier today, and this was a segment we started last year. I gotta move the thing. Nope, that's not the thing I wanna move. Come on. That's not it. There, that's it. All right, I don't know if you can see this. Let's make it a little bit bigger. I wish there was a skip intro button on my crochet so I didn't have to chain 372. I feel this. I don't like the chain. Yes, there is the chainless foundation stitch that you can do, but I hate chaining. Hate it. But that is tonight's meme of the stream. If anybody has any memes that they would like to possibly contribute to the meme of the stream segment, pop that in the Discord. I have a meme section, I think. We'll check here in a second. Let's move that out of the way. Let me just double check my... Yes, I have a meme of the stream. So I need to pull from that... going forward. Yeah. Well, the 372 isn't that I mind. It's also the working. Yes, working into the chain. Prefer chainless foundations because, yes, stretchable. Yes, that is a benefit of the chainless foundation. And thank you, Seagam, for the donkey song. So we are not getting anything done today. Well, no, we did. We learned how to do the cross ripple stitch. So we did learn some things. All right. Thank you, Seagam, for the redeem. And I got to do this from way back. My ears have to be way back. Not up here, way back. And we got to get the music. Let's pause this here. Just go up a hook size. Yes, go up a hook. Hook size could be more roomy as well. Alrighty, here we go. Oh, we're gonna do the little ones. We're not doing the big ones. We're doing the sweetly sings the donkey at the break of day. If you do not feed him, this is what he'll say. Eat-aw, 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 eat-aw. Thank you, Seagam. We appreciate that. All right, we're going to try to get maybe something started. Again, if anybody has anything they want to post in the Discord, feel free to do that. Just let me know that you have done so I can go and check that out. We're going to attempt to start this doily. I've never made this doily. Let's get the music back. So many things. So, all right, let's resize. What? Why can't I resize the thing? Oh, because that the. Let's not rotate. Scroll. Yes, yes, yes. No, yeah, we don't. We want everything to be TOS compliant on the Discord, please. Gonna hop in bed. It was nice causing chaos. Nope. Yeah, get some sleep. I will chat with you later. And thank you, Sam, for lurking. Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome to show you how to do the stitch. That is the core of my channel. It's all about teaching and education. That is one of the main reasons I started this channel. And if there's any other stitches that any crochet stitches that somebody wants to learn, feel free to put that in the suggestion section over on my Discord. Yes, I have a suggestion channel. So that could be anything for the stream. It could be a stitch to learn that you want to learn, want me to teach. It could be a project. It could be a feature. It could be any type of thing, any suggestions. So again, as long as it's TOS compliant, so we don't want any things to be flagged and don't want the channel to be shut down. All right. Thank you for the follow, Mariam. How are you? That is some red thread. Yes, this color is Victory Red. And I don't remember what this is. This is there. Oh, it's not showing up because the camera doesn't like red. This is actually a little bit more of a duller red. This is the red I used for the fan. And you know what? I shouldn't be using red with this because of the camera, but I don't have any pink. I don't want to do this in white because white's kind of boring. I mean, if it's really going to be distracting and you're not going to be able to see it, I can use another color. I don't really have any other thing that would be work for. You could see the difference. Yeah, yeah, yeah. If my hands are here. If my hands aren't, sometimes it'll. Oh, no, it'll stay. Yeah, this is more of like a tomato red. That might have been what it was called. And this is more of a darker. They call it a victory red. Okay. Yeah, I know that's an issue with a lot of cameras is showing, picking up red. But it's a Valentine's thing, and I have no pink. And I've got to get my light back up. So if there's a glare, oh, excuse me, I apologize for that. And we're going to zoom in. If anybody wants this pattern, it will pop up in the Discord. I mean, in the Discord. Well, we'll be in the Discord. It'll pop up in the chat. Exclamation heart will get you the pattern. You don't have to make it in the thin thread that I'm using. You can always, with most patterns, you can always go up a size. You'd have to just have a bigger piece. But this was written for size 10 cotton thread. And let's see. And let's scroll. All right, they're starting with a chain four and a slip stitch, but I am going to do a magic ring because I like the magic ring. So we need 16. Okay. Fortunately, seeing of an overabundance of pink yarn for someone who doesn't care for pink. No, I got pink yarn. I just don't have no pink. I don't have any pink crochet thread. But yes, this is a free pattern from, what is the name of the website? Draiguna? Draiguna. Um, It's something that I came across on a Facebook group the other week. It's like, oh, that's really pretty. And I was like, okay, is this going to be one of those clickbait and it's a picture and then you click on it and it's for something else? No, it's the actual pattern. I'm in. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. Barely see this. 13. 14. 15. And 16. I can see this. It's not as bad. There's this project I'm doing. I can't show it on stream. It's a project I'm doing for Vintage SoGal's spring ornament exchange. And I don't want to show it on stream in case, like, whoever I end up getting paired with gets the item. So I don't want to spoil the surprise. But it's using a much smaller hook. Okay. I got to see where my slip stitch needs to go. So that's round one, chain one, single in the same stitch, chain three, single, oops, skip a double, single in the next. Seven times. Wait a minute. Wait. Okay. Two, three. Skip one. Gonna place the yarn order for your mosaic blanket tonight. Got commissioned to do a baby blanket. Before I can start my blanket, though, it's going to be a mosaic. Found an adorable pattern on Etsy. Nice. Very, very cool. We'd love to see progress pictures. Hey there, Mama Rita. How are you? I got commissioned to do two pieces. Well, technically, I guess there are three. Friend online likes the candy corn that I did back in October, and they want one of these. They want it smaller, so I might have to find some yarn that's thinner. And they also want a pair of fingerless gloves, but I told them, go to the craft store, one of the big box stores, find the yarn that you like, let me know, because they live out of state. So I was like, you let me know and I'll buy it here locally, because don't be buying it and then shipping it and then I got to ship it back to you. That makes no sense. So I'm waiting for them to get back to me so they can tell me what yarn they like. So how are you, Mama Rita? I am attempting to make this, I'm calling it a heart doily. I'm not going to be trying to pronounce that French word. I can barely speak English, much less French. You have to be careful sometimes. The yarn affects the pattern. Yes. It's definitely not a, yeah, it's not a long doily. It's a heart doily. Okay. Two, three, four. Seven. Half double. First single. Okay, I understand why they did that. Okay. Round three. Beginning four cluster using same. We're really trying to figure out this pattern here. More double crochet cluster. Okay, I think I know what they mean. One, two. Wait, no. This pattern, the way it's written, round three, beginning. Four double crochet cluster using the same working in the two chain circles. Okay, this is a little confusing. I think I figured it out. I think I might have figured it out. Yeah, it'll be beautiful. If I can get to the third round. I think there's 23 rounds. Okay. Getting in. Yeah, if anybody wants this, !heart will get you the link. It is a free pattern. I'm working in the two. Okay. Did we do chain two? We do chain two. Yes. Okay. We chain two. One, two. Yarn over. Insert it into that. Go through two. Yarn over. And go into the next. You love my look with my beard? Thank you. I'm actually probably going to be shaving here soon. It's starting to get on my nerves. And then yarn over and go through all four. Okay, yes, that's what we do. Okay, let's see. Okay. I think I figured that out. Okay, now we do the Faka. Now we do Faka. That. 2, 3, 4, 5. I got it. I gotta just had to know where these clusters were going. Wait. Should there be 5? 5 loops? No. Why are there 5 loops? Why are there 5? Yeah. Why are there 5 loops? Maybe there should, wait. No, there should be 5 loops. Not the first time I've done double crochet cluster stitches. Okay. You know, this is the very first time I've ever experienced a hook squeaking. A lot of people say that like they don't like it because it squeaks. I've never experienced it. This hook squeaks. It's not bothering me. It's not really that bad. Maybe I need to clean this hook. Nah. That will never happen. Stepper wax, yeah. Hey there, Shadow Arch. Yeah, I am not cleaning this hook. I understand putting the hook through like a bar of soap or a thing of wax, like a candle. It's not bothering me. I can barely hear it. It's actually not doing it as much. How are you, Shadow Arch? Redo this. Doing all right? Yep, I'm pretty good. I gotta keep track of the time. When did I put the hat and the monk costume on? That was right when we came back from ad. Yeah. So that's been about almost a half hour. So a couple more minutes. I was going to give it longer. I'm pretty good. Yeah, I wasn't in bad spirits. Tuesday, I wasn't feeling well. It was so rainy and cold. My hands did not work. Like my ankles. Yeah, my ankles. My hands and my joints. 2, 3, 4. It hurt. It even hurt to type. So I was like, yeah, that ain't happening. And then yesterday, it was a family thing that happened. Everything's fine. Everything's good. So I was going to stream yesterday, but I didn't get home till late. So that is why there was no stream the past 2 days. And that is why I am here tonight and not Granny Karen.
Two.
I think I'm doing this right. Yeah, we're starting to make something. Hands have been bad for 4 or 5 days. Yeah. Yeah, we just got a lot of rain on Tuesday. And we're supposed to get more rain tomorrow. What is this saying? How do I end this? Oh, wait. Wait, where's the chain two? Chain five. Wait. Oh, that's where I'm at here. Okay. Oh, it's chain two. The way this pattern is written is confusing me. One, two, double into the thing. Big snowstorm, another coming, starting tomorrow into Saturday. Love winter, but not all of that in one darn week. Yeah, I'm okay with it being cool, but not cold, cold, cold. And I don't want the snow, or the ice, or the sleet, or any of that. So, that is why, brain fart. Yeah, like I said, I don't mind it being cold, but not freezing cold. I've done three rounds. Took me that long to do it. Four. Got a chain one. Three singles. Two and three, chain three, and slip stitch. We're making a pico. We're making a pico already. Okay, we did a pico. Three, one. Two, three, and then one, two, three, do the pico. One, two, three. The picture. So small, I can't even see these little picos in the main picture. You're not going to be able to see them yourself. Okay. Two. Three. I think it's been about a half an hour. I can get rid of the turkey and the monk costume. So I will be right back. Hair is probably a mess. It's already a mess. Get rid of that. Pico. Hopefully this is showing up on camera. Kinda. And red is not the best color for cameras. As I'm wearing a red shirt. This was not planned. It was the shirt that I grabbed. Where do I find my doily patterns? Anywhere, actually. Most of the patterns that I have found... This is a modern pattern. The ghost one that I did at Halloween, that's a modern pattern. But most of them... are from this website here. Free Vintage Crochet. Lots and lots of old patterns. They're written. They've been. They were in like magazine or pamphlets. I guess magazines. They were in these types of pamphlets. Okay. Actually, some of these, if I remember correct, that one there, this one here, this flower edging one, is on that site. Some of these other ones might be also. But they have other things besides just doilies there. They've got baby blankets, all different baby stuff, bedspreads, chair sets, because back in the day you would have a crocheted piece that would go on the head part of your chair and the arms of your chair. Christmas patterns, coasters, curtains, edgings. All different types of stuff. I mean, the list goes on and on. And they're adding stuff all the time. Also, check out... this website. Now, this website is a little bit more difficult to navigate. Antique Pattern Library. It's just not crochet. It's all different types of... hobbies and crafts. There's even woodworking in there, basket making. Book binding, all different types of things. Trying to search through everything can be a little difficult. The pattern, let me see here. And the Antique Pattern Library has got a lot of patterns from like the 1800s. The first one, the Vintage Crochet, that's mostly the first half of the 1900s into like the 60s. But the Antique Pattern Library, they even have tatting patterns. But again, navigating it is a little difficult. But this piece here, this filet crochet piece, came from the Antique Pattern Library. So the main piece, I think it was from like 1911. Now the edging that I did here, I did the edging the other week on stream. The edging came from the Free Vintage Crochet site. And the edging, I think is, if I remember correctly, it might be from the 30s. So it would still work. I mean, there is a time frame between the two. But I found one that would kind of coordinate. I still have to block this, especially for the edging. So you can find... all different, but again, for the Antique Pattern Library, you're going to be scrolling through a lot of PDF files that they've uploaded to. So you can't really just type in chicken fillet pattern. You got to click on a lot of it, a lot of things, and just scroll and look and look and look and read. And it's basically photocopied. Or not photocopied, you can tell my age, photocopied, scanned into it. Yeah. Yep. This is a vintage pattern and it still looks great in well over 100 years. Because, again, this part is from 1911, so... Yeah. There's another... Did I get it from there? I gotta look for it. I didn't do this on stream. Gotta find my picture. I did this off stream, and originally I found this pattern. Okay, why can't I? Oh, it's because the thing. I can't. I'm having not computer issues, it's user issues. It's me. There's a YouTuber called Just Vintage. Wait, is it Just Vintage Crochet? No. What is her? What is Karina's channel? It's in my Discord. Let me scroll up and see if I can find the name of the channel. And the link for the Antique Pattern Library is in my Discord. Maybe the free Vintage Crochet might be in there. Yes. Yes. You'll just have to scroll up. It's in the resources channel. So those links are in there. But I'm trying to find this YouTube channel. Just Vintage Crochet is the YouTube channel. And she finds old patterns and actually makes them. And there's some mystery ones. Trying to find a pattern similar to something that my great-grandmother made. When it made from the 30s-ish. Yes. Check out those sites. But the Just Vintage Crochet site, she was doing a pattern. It was a mystery one. Her son will take the written pattern and tape over anything that's going to give away what it is. And she has to do it. She has to pick numbers out of a hat and try to interpret a pattern written in the 1800s and try to figure out what they're talking about. And then when it's done, we have this thing, and she can kind of see what it is. And then when it's done, take off the tape, and she goes, that's what it's supposed to be. Well, there was this doily she was doing. She got most of it done, and she got to a point that she couldn't figure it out. And I found the pattern, and I think I was able to do it. And it's this doily here. This is a pattern from the 1840s. And it's about, I used size 10 thread and I think a 2-something millimeter hook. I use a bigger hook. It's about almost 2 feet across. So there are lots of resources for vintage patterns out there. But I would definitely check out those two links that I gave. And again, they're in the Discord in the resources section. Hey there, goody. Good two shoes. I want to say goody two shoes. Okay, need to zoom in a little. But that's where I get a lot of them, or from some of these pamphlets. These are from back in the 30s, 40s, 50s. And I got these on eBay, or Etsy, one of the two. Not that one. We've done a few of these. Granny Karen, when she comes back, she needs to bring back the mystery. She's got a mystery thing that she does where she spins a wheel, and it will tell her which pattern in this book that she'll do. They're edging, so they're decorative edging for handkerchiefs and linens. She's going to know it's from the book. She doesn't know which one. She doesn't have time to practice it and read it over. So sight unseen, she goes through and will do one of these. She's done a bunch of them. I think I did some too. I know I've done that one. I did not like that one. That was not my favorite. What's some other ones? If I remember, I think we did that one. You can just tell by looking at them because I've got the samples here. We might have done one of those, but yeah, there's lots of lots of resources around. Let's zoom in a little bit more. When I get to the end of this row, this round, which we're almost to, I think we're going to find somebody to raid to. I am getting very hungry. So, I know it's going to be a shorter stream. It's only been 2 hours. What did you miss? Hey there, Grammy. Yes, we're going to attempt to make this doily that's in this picture. I'm on round 4 of this doily. But yeah, when we're done this round, which we're almost to, we're going to find somebody to raid to. And, 3, 1, 2, 3. Because I am hungry. I will be back on Saturday. If we have electricity. Because we're supposed to get more rain and storm coming through tomorrow. Yeah, I saw this pattern on a Facebook group the other week, and I was like, that is like really pretty, and it's three-dimensional. It's using front post and back post stitches, and it's gonna have a raised effect on it. I don't know what I'm gonna use this for, but it's kind of fun to make. And 3, 2, 3. Oh, I gotta resize this application here. Do 3 into here. 2, 3. That's still going to make what I need. Oh. Wait. Why? Wait. I got a frog. I only got a frog out to here. Because there should be more picos. And I'm like, wait a minute. Okay, we're going to frog to here. Hey there, Gary. How are you? Welcome in. One, two, three. Just a curious brain cell. If you want womp womp, go into the channel points and, I was going to say redeem sad green. All right. So we will finish this round. It's going to take longer to get there. So you have a little bit more of.
Most ungrateful children ever conceived. The only reason people are nice to me is because I have more money than God. Now I'm not about to open a new can of worms. Please, maybe you can think about coming down to the guidance center and talking to someone with that help.
I'm not crazy, Malin.
I've just been in a very bad mood for 40 years.
And this is a long clip. Okay, that's good. While that's playing, I'm going to try to figure out this pattern. know. I know what I did was doing wrong. Thank you for that, Gary. All right. How are you? I'm trying to decipher this pattern because I'm kind of a little stumped because I got thought I was done and then I'm like, that didn't look right. Three singles, chain three, say three singles in that, and now we do a pico. Okay. Okay. I was doing the picos in the wrong spots. Two, three. Now a pico. Every time I say pico, I want pico de gallo. I know it's a different type of pico, spelled differently. We're getting it. We're getting it. We're doing it. I think we're doing it the right way. Let's hope. Two. One, two, three, do the pico. Three, two, three, eight. Counting a lot of threes on this round. I'm going to snooze the ad break. So that was two, three, one, two, three. Do the pico. Come on. Picos are not my favorite because you're going into the chain. And then three singles. One, two. Three, chain one, half double into the first. Yes, that looks much, much better than, supposed to have little bumps all the way around. I only had bumps like on half of them. Again, I know the red is not really showing up that great with my camera. At this point, I am going to tighten my magic ring. Got a fair bit there. And I guess I could weave in my end. Let me find my little needle. That's a sharp one, but that'll still work. Pop this. On Saturday, I'm going to do the Project Linus blanket. That's usually what we do on Saturdays. And I need to finish it. It's been going on way too long, and I think I'm almost to the end of that second colorway of yarn that I got. It's like the baby pastels. I think we will have a finish tomorrow. Not tomorrow. Saturday. That is my plan, my goal. I want to get that done and over with. So that is the first four rounds of this doily. It looks like it's that center there. Yeah, it's that center. Then I think the next rounds is we're going to start building up the things for the hearts that face out. Yeah. Hey there, Upcycly. Welcome in. And we're actually getting ready to raid out. Let's move my hooks and everything around. All right, let's turn off that light. We don't need it. Thanks, everybody, for hanging out with me. And again, sorry for not being around the past 2 days. I am back. I need to do the thing. So check out my YouTube channel. Over 190 videos over there. All of my streams are posted over there when I'm done streaming. I have a Discord, which most of you here know about. Share any of your pictures, whatever you're working on, any of that good stuff. So check that out. I have a merch store. If you want to support me, besides throwing money at Twitch, if you throw money at my store, not only do you support the stream, you get something in return. We haven't been to the merch store in a while, so let's see what we have over in the land of the Crafty Cubs merch store. So let's bring over the... Come on. Bring it over. Yeah, bring it up. I'm talking to myself. All right, we have some tote bags. So you can pick yourself up a good project bag. I know Clean Miko has one of these. And they come in the Proud Dirty Hooker pattern, either the blue or the pink. Additionally, if you are not the Proud Dirty Hooker, you can get all of these items in what I'm calling the Crochet Terms pattern. So it's just a word cloud of crochet terms. So pick yourself up a tote bag. If you need a hoodie, both zip up and pull over. We've got you covered over there. They go up to all different sizes, both small and plus sizes. We also have t-shirts. So get yourself a t-shirt. And in addition to that, we've got stainless steel, 32-ounce stainless steel water bottles. I know Grammy ETC has one of these, and it can keep your beverages really cold for a long time, and it can hold up to a standard bottle of wine if you are a wine drinker and don't want to get your crochet work stained and messed up with your wine. That is one way of protecting that. And again, you can, like I said, support the channel. And we also have accessory pouches. Let me show the pink version. So this is the pink, design. And all of the items will say the Crafty Cob on the back. Oh, thank you, Knitter Girl. That is the clip of when she was showing off the cat sweater that she made. Yes, if you're not following up Psych Lee, check her out. We shared the square that she was working on, that she posted in my Discord earlier, of the blanket for her stepdaughter. So, head on over there. She is also another Mocha Loco like I am. So, back to the merch store. This is the merch store. Again, support, a good way to support the stream and getting something in return for your support instead of just saying, here, Twitch, take my money. I mean, yes, I get a portion of it from Twitch as well. But, yeah. So, I think that's all I was going to mention. We're going to go and see. Yes, I know where we're going to go. I think this may be a... I think we're going to probably make it a Thursday thing. I usually don't like try to raid the same people all the time. But I think on Thursdays we are going to raid this person going forward. A wonderful, wonderful streamer. Oh, before we do this, I'm going to get the raid call. I forgot to do the raid call. So, copy the raid call, everybody, if you will, and paste that into the raid once we raid in, just to show them some support and some love, and to let them know that you are coming for my raid. So, that is the raid call for any followers, and if you are a subscriber, that is the raid call for subscribers. All right. We're going to go and raid to a really, really good streamer, another Mocha Loco. And I consider them a friend. And another fan of some vintage patterns. We're going to go and raid the Traveling Tatter. I think that is going to be our Thursday raids for a while. Since Granny Karen does some vintage stuff and Tatter does vintage stuff, I think we're going to keep that same thing if she's still streaming when we raid out. So again, I'll be on Saturday evening at 6 p.m. for Project Linus Blankets. I will catch you then. Everybody, stick around for the raid. Copy those raid calls. Show Tatter some love. Even maybe cause some chaos over there. And